So I have the honor to present our international speaker. I don't know if it is the first international speaker on our seminar. But anyways, Eliza Weich, it is one of not very numerous specialists in mathematics without AC. So I don't know how much there are such specialists in our neighborhood. So the talk, it will be topology without choice, right?
Yes, that's
topology without choice. Such optimistic title. Maybe titles will be different. So try to share screen. So the title will be written on the screen. Lisa Weich, she is from University of Sedlice, but born in Łódź, and education is from Łódź and Warsaw. She is a student of Engelking and I forgot. This is a
Filipczak was my supervisor.
Filipczak was formal supervisor, but a seminar of Engelking anyway. So, please.
But I attended a seminar of Professor Engelking in Warsaw.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so we see your presentation, very good. Yes.
Only I want to change my the view to full screen. Mm-hmm. That's
yeah.
Probably.
Okay. Please.
Okay, I've been working, exchanging mathematical ideas with Professor Kyriakos Keremedis from the University of the Aegean in Samos for about 4 years. We have written about 200 pages together. Some of the pages have been converted into articles submitted to journals and already published. Some are in the form of preprints available in ArcSight, and some are still under preparation. One of the newest papers written together with me and Kyriakos Keremedis in cooperation with Eleftherios Tachtsis is devoted to remainders of Hausdorff compactifications, but in the absence of the axiom of choice, as Taras Banach said, we work on topology without the axiom of choice based on Zermelo-Frankel set theory. While working on other problems, we needed compactifications with of discrete spaces, but with but non-scattered Hausdorff compactifications, and we wanted wanted to have a look at compactifications with second countable remainders. Such remainders of locally compact spaces, Hausdorff spaces, are of course metrizable, but in ZF, not every metrizable compact space is. In some models of ZF, not every metrizable compact space is second countable. In 1981, Hatzenmüller and Mattsson published a paper in which they gave several necessary and sufficient conditions for a locally compact Hausdorff space to have all metrizable compact, non-empty compact spaces as remainders. Of course, they had to give conditions, necessary and sufficient conditions for a locally compact Hausdorff space to have the Cantor ternary set as a remainder. Their paper was written in ZFC, and they used the axiom of choice quite heavily. We wanted to preserve some properties of locally compact Hausdorff spaces for ZF, and the ones that we were unable to preserve for ZF, we investigated them in distinct models of ZF. Our results on the remainders of Hausdorff compactifications are included in our joint work with Eleftherios Tachtsis, who was very helpful when we wanted to construct some permutation models. This preprint is available at ArcSight. The paper has been submitted last year. Fundamental introductory results on compactifications in ZF are included in my joint paper with Kyriakos Keremedis, already published in Topology and its Applications. Some surprising results concerning compactifications can be found in my paper with Kyriakos Keremedis, which was accepted for publication in Periodica Mathematica Hungarica last week. Let me recall to you the basic theorem of Hatzenbuehler and Mattson from their paper publishing the Proceedings of the American Mathematical Society in 1981. This is the style. I simply retyped this theorem from their original article without making any changes. So this is how it is written in the article. You can see that they gave conditions A and C that in ZFC are necessary and sufficient for locally compact space X non-compact. They assume that the space is not compact to have every compact metric space. They did not write non-empty, but we guess that they simply assumed that metric spaces are non-empty as a remainder. It occurs that their theorem is not a theorem of ZF. It, as a whole, it fails in some models of ZF. So we could not rescue, especially this condition, for our investigations without assuming the axiom of choice. So we had to modify the conditions, especially this condition C, because it occurs that condition A of theorem of Hatzenbuehler-Mattson theorem is necessary and so sufficient for a locally compact Hausdorff space to have all but second countable compact Hausdorff spaces as remainders. However, condition C must be modified, and this is how we transferred this condition C to a necessary and sufficient condition for X to have every non-empty second countable compact Hausdorff space as a remainder. This looks quite complicated, but we could not simplify it. And In the paper by Hudson, Buller and Madsen, no direct construction of a compactification with a given metrizable compact remainder was shown. We were able to show such a construction, assuming that condition C of our theorem is satisfied. These are such this condition says that a space, a locally compact Hausdorff space has the Cantor ternary set as a remainder if and only if it has such a dyadic family of open sets. It's quite complicated, but this is not, I think, not necessary to remember all these conditions during my talk. How to obtain a compactification with the Cantor ternary set as a remainder in ZF. We assume that the space X satisfies its condition C from our theorem. We choose for it this dyadic family of open sets, and for the Cantor ternary set, we choose a sequence of families of pairwise disjoint Clopen subsets such that A, being the union of such families, is a base of the Cantor set, and the families satisfy these conditions. Oh, it is easy to obtain such families, and we define simply, we may assume that X and the Cantor ternary set are disjoint, and put Y equal to the union of X and the Cantor ternary set, and define a base of a topology in this way, and obtain, this is a
Can I have a question?
Yes.
So it is more natural to index such a family by Cantor tree, which is just also object of ZF. Cantor tree is a set of finite binary sequences. You just take indexing by the upper levels of this Cantor set, right? Because
yes,
Cantor Cantor tree, it has order, which also can be used in ordering these sets simultaneously. So you just would have some set index by Cantor tree, and requirement is that for the each next two, the complement to the union should be compact, right?
Yes, but we discussed this theorem, so we wanted to have our condition as close as possible to the conditions given by Hudson, Buller, and Madsen.
Because there is this natural indexing for such a problem. For such problem of finding Cantor set as remainder, natural indexing is by Cantor tree. And this index set is in ZF, no problem. Yeah, okay, but sorry, maybe I just distract you from the...
No, that's an interesting remark. Thank you for it very much. But we wanted to make only necessary changes in conditions given by Hudson, Buller, and Max. So we define a base of a Hausdorff topology in Y, and this should be an index. This Y as an index should be written. I am sorry. And in this way, we obtained the required compactification. And since every second countable Hausdorff space is a continuous image of the Cantor ternary set, we check that this holds in ZF. We can deduce from our condition C that if a space satisfies this condition C, then every second non-empty second countable house door space is a remainder of X. We wanted to know whether it is possible to construct metrizable compactifications of metrizable locally compact spaces satisfying some conditions. But we, of course, in ZF, and to this aim, we needed a modification of the Urysohn's metrization theorem. As you probably well know, it was shown by Good and Tree in an article published in 1995 in Topology and Its Application, so that Urysohn's metrization theorem holds in ZF. Our modification of this theorem is that it holds in ZF that every T3 space which has a CAF base is metrizable. A CAF base is a base which can be expressed as a countable union of finite sets. And an idea of the proof is written here. Suppose that the T3 space X has a base B, which is a union, a countable union of families Bn, and each one of these families Bn is finite. So having a pair HK of non-empty disjoint closed sets of X, we want to define an operator which will show that the space is effectively normal, simply. So we define sets UN, VN, and this D dot HK is UHVK, whether UH is defined in this way, VK is defined in this way. And using this operator D in the same way as it is done for effectively normal spaces, we can follow the classical proof of Urysohn's lemma and find a function which separates, which has zero on the set, which takes the value zero on H and one on K. So we can embed the space T3 in a Cantor, in the Tychonoff cube 0, 1, 2, F, where F is the collection of such functions and F is a CAP set, is a countable union of finite sets. In my paper presented during the conference TopoSim 2016 and published later it in a special issue of Topology and Its Applications in 2018, I showed that if we have a product of metrizable spaces, a CAF product, this if we have a family XSDS for S belonging to a set S such that this set S is a countable union of finite sets, then the product of the spaces XXS, I am sorry, with topologies generated by their metrics is metrized. So this Tychon of cube is metrizable and X is homeomorphic to a subspace of this Tychon of cube, so it is metrizable. We looked at condition C of Hatzenguller-Matson theorem. Let me show you, oh, this is this condition, and wanted to see, we discovered that this condition is not necessary for a space to have the Cantor ternary set as a remainder, but we wanted to know whether it is at least sufficient. And it occurs that if a locally compact Hausdorff space admits such a sequence postulated by Hatzenguller and Matson, then every non-empty compact second countable Hausdorff space is a remainder of X. And in addition, if X has a CAF base, then every non-empty second countable compact Hausdorff space is a remainder of a metrizable compactification of X. How we can, in this case, we can, assuming that the space X satisfies the assumption of our theorem here, we can simplify our previous construction by defining a base on the space Y, on the set for the space Y, being the union of X and the Cantor ternary set in this way. And now, having this base, we can modify it in the case when X has a CAF base. Mm-hmm. And this base GS is a CAF base of our space Y. So Y as a compact Hausdorff space having a CAF base is also metrizable. What else? For an infinite set D, let us denote by D odd infinity the one point Hausdorff compactification of the discrete space with the underlying set D. To show that Hatzenguller-Matson theorem fails in, as a whole, fails in some model of ZF, we applied amorphous discrete spaces. We say that the discrete space is amorphous in if the set, its underlying set D, space, discrete space D is amorphous. If D is an amorphous set, that means if D cannot be, if D is infinite and every infinite subset of D has finite complement. If D cannot be written as a union of two disjoint infinite subsets. In our paper with basic facts about Hausdorff compactification, in ZF, we showed that if D is an amorphous set and K is, if D is an amorphous set and the bold D is the discrete space with the underlying set D, then D has its checkstone compactification, the checkstone compactification of D is just the one point compactification of D. The space D and beta d times d are both the spaces pseudo-compact, but the product of beta d and beta d is not the checkstone compactification of this space. So in the models of ZF, in which there exists amorphous sets, the famous theorem of Glitzberg fails, saying that if X, Y are pseudo-compact space, Tikhonov spaces, and the product is pseudo-compact, then the checkstone compactification of the product is the product of checkstone compactifications of the spaces X, Y. This Glitzberg's theorem fails, but in the case when we have an amorphous discrete space and a non-empty first countable compact Hausdorff space, then K times the checkstone compactification of D, this is just the one-point compactification of D, is the checkstone compactification of the space K times D. This is a new theorem included in the paper written last year, this one. That one was published in 2019, but I showed it a little earlier at a conference, a workshop on modern applied mathematics in Krakow. The idea of the proof to theorem four, this is this. This one you can find in our article published in Topology and its Applications in 2019. We consider the space X being the Cartesian product of K and D. Y is K times the one-point compactification of D. And we want to show that X is the checkstone compactification of Y. To do it, we take a pair of disjoint closed sets of X and prove that they have disjoint closures in Y. This is sufficient. So suppose that the closures in Y are non-empty. You take a point X0, what can belong to the intersection, the closures have non-empty intersection, a point of the form X0 infinity can be in the common common part of these closures. The space K is first countable, so we have a countable base of neighborhoods of X0. We may assume that that this members of this base Gn are such that Gn plus one is contained in Gn, and consider a set An of all of those T's, indeed, such that Gn ties the singleton with an element T, meets A, and Bn is defined in a similar way. And now we use the assumption that D is amorphous, so the sets must satisfy this condition. Otherwise, we could divide D into disjoint infinite subsets. So if T is in M is such that these equalities holds for every hold both for every n greater than m, and if t is in the common part of am and bm, then x0 t is in the closure, in the common part of the closures of a and b. But this is impossible. And well, since D is amorphous, then AM is finite or BM is finite. Assuming that AM is finite, we have a neighborhood of infinity. Of infinity is the point added to D to as the it is the unique point of the remainder of the Aleksandrov compactification of D, and we consider this at U being the product of GM and V. And this is a neighborhood of the point x0 infinity in y. So it meets the set A. So there exists z0 and y0 in such sets, such that this z0 and y0 is in A. Then y0 is in AM, but this is impossible, and we get a contradiction. Using this theorem 4, we deduce that if D is an amorphous discrete space, and K is a metrizable compact but not second countable space, then the space X, it obviously satisfies the assumptions of condition C of Hetzenbuhler-Matson theorem, but K is not a remainder of X. So in this way, we show that Hetzenbuhler and Matson theorem as a whole is not a theorem of ZF. So it is relatively consistent with ZF that there exists a locally compact Hausdorff space X such that all non-empty compact second countable Hausdorff spaces are remainders of X, but not all non-empty metrizable compact spaces are remainders of X. And a corollary to these facts is that the implications of theorem due to Hetzenbuhler and Matson are unprovable in ZF. This is why Hetzenbuhler-Matson's theorem is not a theorem of ZF. Let me show again the conditions A and B of Hetzenbuhler and Matson theorem. These are the ones so we had to change metrizable in Hetzenbuhler-Matson theorem to second countable compact. And still modify this condition C to have, if we wanted to have all non-empty second countable compact Hausdorff spaces as remainders of a space. It occurs that some independence results about the countable discrete space and can be obtained some new while looking at compactifications of n, especially metrizable ones, since if the statement that all non-empty metrizable compact spaces are remainders of metrizable compactifications of n is equivalent to the statement that every metrizable compact space is separable. This statement is known independent of ZF. This was shown in papers written by Karamadis and Tachtis, and more exactly, the statement every metrizable compact space is separable implies the axiom of countable choices for families of finite sets. From this, we can conclude immediately that the statement that all non-empty metrizable compact spaces are remainders of metrizable compactifications of N also implies C, the axiom of countable choice for families of finite sets. This axiom says that every countable, non-empty countable family of non-empty finite sets has a choice function. In the paper, which was accepted for publication in Periodica Mathematica Hungarica last week, in my opinion, a very surprising result about compactification is included. This is my common result with Kyriakos-Karamadis, namely, we investigated in that paper CAF products and CAF sums of quasi-metrizable spaces. CAF product is a product of spaces XS for S from a set S such that this set S is expressive, can be expressed as a countable union of finite sets. We wanted to investigate when such products can be quasi-metrizable, and we had a look at 1-point and 2-point Hausdorff compactifications of discrete denumerable discrete spaces or discrete spaces that are CAF spaces. This means that the underlying set of such spaces is expressible as a countable union of finite sets, and it occurs, but we can prove in ZF that a countable product of one-point Hausdorff compactifications of denumerable discrete spaces is first countable, if and only if it is quasi-metrizable. But when we pass to two-point Hausdorff compactifications, the problem is more difficult because it occurs that it is unprovable in ZF that for every family, the numerable family of two-point Hausdorff compactifications of the numerable discrete space, the product is first countable if and only if it is quasi-metrizable. That means that in some models of ZF, there exists countable families of two-point Hausdorff compactifications of the numerable discrete spaces, such that the product is first countable without being quasi-metrizable. These are the main results which I wanted to show to you, but I also included to my slides some intriguing open problems that we are unable to solve so far. Namely, when working on Hausdorff compactifications in ZF looking at my paper presented published in 2018 in the special issue of topology and its applications, in which I showed some models of ZF in which some Cantor cubes can be metrizable without being compact. We asked ourselves a question whether it is possible in a model of ZF that a Tychonoff space does not have any Hausdorff compactification. We cannot resolve this problem. And another interesting problem is concerning Cantor cubes. If a Cantor cube is non-compact, it is now it does not have any points of local compactness. And in ZF, we do not know any methods how to construct compactifications of Hausdorff compactifications of such spaces when we do not have a Boolean prime ideal theorem. So an interesting question is whether a metrizable non-compact Cantor cube can be such that it does not have any Hausdorff compactification, of course, in a model of ZF. If it is impossible to find directly a model of ZF in which a metrizable non-compact Cantor cube does not have any Hausdorff compactification, perhaps it is possible to construct at least a permutation model for the sentence there exists a metrizable non-compact Cantor cube which does not have any Hausdorff compactification. We do not see any proof that all Cantor cubes have Hausdorff compactifications. One more problem, but we are unable to solve, is whether it holds in ZF that if R with its natural topology is sequential, then so is R to omega. What we know about it is that the sequentiality of R is equivalent to the sequentiality of R to N for every positive integer N. However, we do not know what to do with R to omega. All methods that we tried to use to to solve this problem were not good enough to get a satisfactory solution of it. Our papers on relevant to the statement R is sequential, it is independent of ZF, the statements, were published in last year, one in topology and disapplication. Its title was on Loeb and sequential spaces in ZF. The other one was published in Journal of Convex Analysis, and it was about densely complete metric spaces and extensions of uniformly continuous functions in ZF. In the paper published in Journal of Convex Analysis, there was our first solution of a problem posed by me in my another joint work with Cenab Ozel and Artur Pienkos and Hanifa Zebhauri, probably this is her name. They involved me in their work concerning Max plus algebras. And they wanted to have a form of vector minimizing theorem for some structures. And I wanted to deliver to them some versions of vector minimizing theorem in ZF, and had a trouble with with some spaces that perhaps were not sequential if R was not sequential. And I asked a question whether the sequentiality of R implies the sequentiality of R to M. And at that time, I was unable to solve it in several days. My co-author wanted to submit the paper, which was already long. So the paper appeared with an open problem. And when Kyriakos Karamedi started to work with me more intensively, I recalled to myself the problem that I posed, and we solved it more or less together, but with some very useful idea given to me by Kyriakos Karamedis in the paper published in the Journal of Convex Analysis. About that paper was about densely complete spaces, but later, somewhat later, we found another solution of this problem and included in the paper on Loeb and sequential spaces in ZF. We used in that paper Hilbert cube, but Hilbert cube is compact. So when we had Hilbert cube, we had no problem with showing that if R is sequential, then the Hilbert cube 0, 1 to omega is sequential, but R to omega is not locally compact, and we did not know how to deal with non-locally compact spaces when we were writing our paper on Loeb and sequential spaces in ZF. Since this is all what I type in my slide, perhaps it is reasonable to show to you some of the papers that what has happened here.
It does not react on your, it shows us some slide in the middle, 10th slide of 19. Yeah, okay.
I hope that this can be seen. Mm-hmm. So this is the paper accepted for publication in the Periodica Mathematica Hungarica. Let me move to the result, which says that it is unprovable in ZL that if a countable product of 2-point Hausdorff compactifications of denumerable discrete spaces is first countable, then it is also quasi-metrized. The original result that we have, this is a long paper for 40 pages. Oh, you can see what we have. Oh, maybe. Mm-hmm. How we could resolve that problem of 2-point, this is this. May I do something to have no, because on my right side, I have participants of this meeting. And this makes it okay, but now it has improved. This makes me hard to see the whole text.
So everybody has possibility to move back and forth the dividing line between the slide and the participants. It does not depend on you. For example, in my screen, I have a large your presentation and small strip with participants. No problems.
This is the theorem in which we show. We considered just, we denoted it CP2PHC, quite complicated notation. The statement for every family YN with N in omega of 2-point Hausdorff compactifications of denumerable discrete spaces, we mean by denumerable set, a countable set which is infinite. The product is quasi-metrizable if and only if it is first countable. And we could show that this statement such a statement this junction with PC Aleph 0 to omega, in a way I can show to you, we made a list of forms used in this paper. This will be. And there was a problem with finding a model. Oh, this will be. Oh, well, I have it. Oh, there is. There. This statement PC Aleph 0 to infinity is equivalent to the statement every denumerable disjoint family of two element sets has a choice function. But it is defined in a more complicated way, but CMC omega is equivalent to the statement that every denumerable family of denumerable sets has a multiple choice function. When we have a family XS for S in a set S, then we say that this family has a multiple choice function if there is a function which assigns to every S a finite non-empty subset of XS. So the disjunction of the statement CMC omega and PC Aleph 0 to infinity implies the disjunction follows from this statement. So this means because there is a model for this disjunction, we did not know, but when we wanted to resolve whether countable products of two-point Hausdorff compactifications of denumerable discrete spaces, if this product is first countable, then it is quasi-metrizable. We did not know whether this is probable in ZF or it is not. So we discovered first that the statement that every countable product of 2-point Hausdorff compactifications of denumerable discrete spaces, if it is first countable, then it is quasi-metrizable, implies the disjunction of the statement that every countable family of 2-point sets has a choice function and the CMC omega. And next, we try to find a model for the conjunction of the negation of this statement and this one. And the model, what we found, is simply we used M-inf, the model denoted by M15 in the book, but this is Fevermann-Blass model in the book by Paul Howard and Jane Ruby. Namely, in this model, we denote it for simplicity by M. there is a sequence of generic reals such that when this is the symmetric difference, if we for a set X contained in omega define delta X as a set of generic reals AN such that the symmetric difference of it is finite, then we have a function, we can define a function in this way. And this is a function which assigns to every M two element set. This is a definition of this model M infty, but what we show is that this family R is in M. is in this model, and this R does not have a partial choice function in the model. They are countable, the sets are countable. The sets are countable because they are subsets of omega. That so we have a set A and which is a union of these two sets. It is these two sets. It is countable, and this set A n it is in a power set of omega. So we may identify the family of such sets from the definition of the model M15 with subsets of R. The sets are disjoint. If the family AM would have a partial multiple choice function, then R, this family R, would have a partial choice function in M infty, but this in M15, but it was shown in a paper by Tachtsis that this family R does not have any partial choice function in M15. A partial choice function, if we have a family XS for S in S offsets, then a partial choice function is a choice function of a family XS for S belonging to some set T, where T is an infinite subset of X. So we use a result of Tachtsis. This shows that this principle CMC omega fails in this Blas Fermat-Blass model, M15. So such an argument is used here. What else has been done? This is more complicated. I think that this just was the most complicated part of this paper, but interestingly, in my opinion, an interesting result, in my opinion, is that such statement, such statements, independent of ZF, this is a non-statement. It says that every CAF union, czyli every countable of CAF sets, every union of CAF sets that can be represented as a union of finite families of CAF sets is a CAF set. And this one says that every countable union of CAF sets is a CAF set. Let me recall to you that a CAF set is a set which can be expressed as a countable union of finite sets. So the two statements, each one of the statements is equivalent to the statement that every CAF product of cofinite CAF spaces, cofinite means that with cofinite topology, is quasi-metrizable. And is equivalent also to the statement that every CAF product of one-point Hausdorff compactifications of infinite discrete CAF spaces is quasi-metrizable. However, when we look at the statement UT Aleph 0 Aleph 0 CAF, this is, it says that every countable union of countable sets is a CAF set. Then it is equivalent to the statement that every CAF product of one-point Hausdorff compactifications of denumerable discrete spaces is quasi-metrizable. For instance, you can see here more statements equivalent to the ones. We used in this corollary to our theorems from which we deduced that corollary, we used a paper by Paul Howard and Eleftherios Stachis, in which the authors solved my problem posed in Prague in 2016. The problem was, is there a model of ZF in which there is a metrizable compact Cantor cube which is not second Cantor? I had models in which there were metrizable Cantor cubes but non-compact. But I wanted to have a model in which there is a metrizable compact, but not second countable Cantor cube. And I know from Paul Howard and Lefteris that they found this problem very interesting, but very hard. However, they successfully solved that problem, and their solution is published, was published this year. This is a newly published paper in topology and its applications. They constructed a new model of a new permutation model in which there is a metrizable compact Cantor cube, which is not second countable, and they also used some investigations and to resolve the problem and some relevant ones, the statements Utica-Kafkaev and this one, and showed some equivalences. So exactly which ones? I can show it to you. And Paul Howard and Tachtsis used Yechsohor first embedding theorem to move the statement of the ones are not equivalent. This is a known result already. Oh, this is a very nice theorem by Howard and Tachtsis, where they show that this UT Aleph 0 Kaf Kaf implies CMC omega, and this implies this, and but the implications, none of the implications given there is reversible. This one, this sentence was introduced by me. This is countable product of products of quasi-metrizable spaces are quasi-metrizable. So it is independent of the depth, it implies this. And this one is unprovable in ZF. And in the same paper, Paul Howard and Tachtsis just showed solution to my problem and a new permutation model in which there is a compact metrizable Cantor cube, which is not second counter. But we applied this part of the results obtained by Paul Howard and Eleftherios Tachtsis in the paper. And we also applied, as you could see, some properties of the model M15 proved earlier by Eleftherios Tachtsis. This paper is written only by me and Kyriakos Karamedis, but the one of second countable Hausdorff spaces as remainders is written by me and Kyriakos Karamedis and Eleftherios Tachtsis. The contribution of Eleftherios Tachtsis was to give us a huge help in the construction of a model of permutation model. I wanted to show you this construction, the description of a model in which a space, discrete space, can be weakly Dedekind finite. This means that the underlying set of the space is such that its power set is dedicated finite, but the space can still have all second countable Hausdorff spaces as remainders. Oh, this is also a long paper. Oh, this will be a model. This one. In this paper, we also gave necessary and sufficient conditions for a space to have the one-point compactification, to have omega plus one as a remainder. And this led us to introduce two new forms. One form is every infinite discrete space has the Cantor ternary set as a remainder. It is a topological definition of a form that can be, of this form that can be also defined in an equivalent way. Or this will be probably the model. No, this is another. This is also an interesting model in which there is a denumerable collection of amorphous sets which does not have any partial multiple choice set, but in this one, we have a model, another of probably what is it shown there. In this theorem, we show that the conjunction of the Boolean prime ideal theorem and the statement that there exists an infinite set, an infinite discrete space, which does not have omega plus one as a remainder, has as a def model. To show it, we prove that in the Mostovsky linearly ordered model N3, it is a notation from Paul Howard's book, the Boolean prime ideal theorem holds, but there exists, this is known, that in this model, the Boolean prime ideal theorem holds. But what is new is that there is an infinite discrete space which does not have omega plus one as a remainder. And we check that this statement using Pincus transfer theorem, that this conjunction is transferable to a model of ZF. But I am sorry, this model where we prove that there is as an infinite discrete space, which has the Cantor cube as a remainder, The Cantor ternary set as a remainder, but is weakly dedecant finite, is in another paper. And I did not open it, that another paper, but you can find it in my paper with Kyriakos Keremedis and Eleftherios Tachtis, tied on isodense and scattered spaces in ZF. While writing this paper, we did not realize that such a model can be also found. What else can be said is that the statement that every infinite space which has omega plus one, discrete space which has omega plus one as a remainder, is must be weakly Dedekind infinite, is not provable in ZF. So this is a model. This is a permutation model, but if this one is simpler, this is a description here in this proof of a permutation model of ZFA with atoms, in which the statement that every the statement there exists a strongly an infinite discrete space which is Dedekind finite but still has omega plus one as a remainder. That this statement is true in this permutation model. And the permutation model is described here. We consider a model of ZFA satisfying the axiom of choice and use the group with the ZA of atoms, which is a denumerable which can be partitioned into a denumerable family of infinite sets, and use the group of permutations of the set of atoms having some special properties, such properties as here needed, and define a filter of subgroups of this group G, which is generated by a filter base defined in a not in a very complicated way, but you see this is a rather hard part of the paper. So if you are interested, you can find this proof in our preprint. But the more complicated model is the one in which there is a weakly Dedekind finite discrete space, which has all non-empty second countable Hausdorff spaces as remainders. Is more complicated than this one. This one, this model is, the description is simpler and simpler reasoning are applied when we ask about infinite discrete spaces that have omega plus one as remainder. So it is possible that such a space can have omega one as a remainder, omega one plus one as a omega plus one as a remainder, but be weakly Dedekind finite. And so thank you. My time is over. So thank you very much for your attention. And I enclosed my slides here. I noticed only one minor typo there, where the index was written in the same line as the set which I wanted to index.
Okay, thank you. Dziękujemy bardzo. Thank you for nice talk. Maybe someone has questions or suggestions or solution of problems, whatever. You have unique choice, unique opportunity to ask what happens without choice. You have such a choice.
There is a hand there.
Hands is just applauds, but so if there is no comments, I have one comment, maybe even solution of your problem concerning R to power omega. Because if R is sequential, right? The question if sequentiality of R implies sequentiality of R to countable power, right? So just we can represent R as the image of Cantor cube minus one point effectively, right? With Cantor cube times naturals basically. And then this image, real line, it is image of Cantor cube minus point and the image under some effectively written maps, so Cantor this Cantor ladder. And then take this to countable power and you will obtain that Cantor cube times naturals to countable power maps in a perfect way with compact three images of points to countable power of real line, right? Then sequentiality, as far as I understand, problem of sequentiality of countable power of R reduces to problem of sequentiality of now Cantor space times irrationals. Countable power of natural numbers times countable power of Cantor set, it is still countable, still Cantor sets times irrationals because everything is effective, it is ZF constructions. And now the problem is actually this one, if sequentiality of real line implies the sequentiality of irrationals. Because irrationals, there is a perfect map from irrationals to countable power of real lines. And now this is also can be resolved. It is true. So sequentiality of real line implies sequentiality of irrationals because if you have non-closed set in irrationals, so you just take one limit point, you know that such limit point exists. And then you can choose neighborhoods of rationals. You can effectively enumerate rationals. So you can find open neighborhood of all rationals, which still does not destroy this limit point from irrationals. And then if you find limit point in this set, which is inside of R, is compact set of, not compact, it is set which has compact closure in irrationals. And this proves you this sequentiality of irrationals. Probably this is just idea, but I hope that it works.
Well, thank you very much. Perhaps we did not think about it intensively enough.
Okay.
But it would be nice if you could type your solution.
Okay. I will try.
Show it to us. We would be great.
Okay.
But we would know what to do with how to new constructions of compactifications, how to compact.
That is a very good question. As I understand that you have you don't have any others, you have only two constructions of compactification. One is Hilbert cube over Kaff family, right? Is Urysohn.
Yes, but this cannot be used because Tikhonov cubes need not be compact. In some
model. Right. So just simply there is no tools for constructing compactification. Only this Orison and one point, and none of them works, right?
Sometimes it is possible, as we showed in this paper, to add a concrete space, but when a space is locally compact, to add it directly.
Locally compact, yes, exactly. But if not, then there is no way to compactify except for this Orison-like, and it's very restricted method, right? That is a problem.
And the Dekkers, what if we have in ZFC every Hausdorff compactification of the Tikhonov space X is strictly described by the set of all those continuous real functions of on X that are continuously extendable over this compactification. But in ZF, it may happen that two non-equivalent compactifications of the same space X have the same rings of functions that are continuously extendable over
the compactification. I understand that simply compactification which are constructed using functions, they are not compact. That is the problem, right? Because of non-compact of Tikhonov cube. So you have,
and even if in this way one can obtain a compact space, one cannot compare compactifications in ZF by using the rings of continuous functions extendable over continuously extendable over such compactifications.
Yes. Okay. Maybe more questions, comments. So I understand the compactness does not behave well without this Boolean ideal, and that is the root of problems, right? Compactness is somehow.
But as you see, without the axiom of choice, quite interesting results can be obtained, and a lot can be said about the behavior of some mathematical objects in distinct models of ZF. But so far as permutation models and their constructions are concerned, I am still a beginner. So I am just learning how to construct them, and in each time when I have some doubts whether I have done everything in the model well enough, I ask Eleftherios Stachis, because he is very good at it and he knows a lot about permutation models. But I am also making some progress.
Good.
As far as I understood from your recent remark that we don't assume the axiom of choice, then there may be some Tikhonov cubes which are not compact and non-empty simultaneously. Yes, non-empty and non-compact.
Yes.
What is the simplest example of the kind?
It is known that the Boolean prime ideal theorem is equivalent to the statement that all products of compact Hausdorff spaces are compact, and it is equivalent to the statement that all Tikhonov cubes are compact. So in every model in which the Boolean prime ideal theorem fails, there are Tikhonov cubes that are not compact.
Okay, thanks.
And in my paper published in 2018 in Topology and Its Applications in the special issue of this journal, there are shown some properties that imply that there are also metrizable Cantor cubes that are non-comp. That time I did not know papers written by Kriakor Skremedis in which non-compact Cantor cubes were considered and in which similar conditions to the ones found by me were also formulated. This is why I did not refer that time to some papers of Kriakos Keremedis or Tachtis, because I was not aware of that papers. But I could find non-compact metrizable Cantor cubes in some models, but could not find a compact metrizable and not second countable. The ones were found by Howard and Tachtis, but in a new permutation model constructed by them. The models known before were not good enough for Paul Howard and Tachtis. They could not find such cubes.
But return to the question of Misha. So Tikhonov cubes, they are just intervals to some power, or?
Yes, Tikhonov cubes are intervals to some powers. Hilbert cube is the interval 0, 1 close to omega.
But it is compact always, right? So
this one is always compact. This one is compact.
Okay, okay.
But this is not in some models, not the unique metrizable Tikhonov cube.
Yeah, yeah. Right.
Metrizable are the ones.
They are not homeomorphic, or what? There are Hilbert cubes which are not homeomorphic, you mean?
Yes.
Uh-huh.
Hilbert cubes can be metrizable. Hilbert Tikhonov cubes need not be homeomorphic in some models of
seven. Mm-hmm. Very good. Okay, more questions? So if not, let us thank the speaker again. There are reactions. Good. Także dziękujemy bardzo, Pani Eliza.
Dziękuję również. Przepraszam, że nie wszystko dobrze tam mi poszło. Może trochę za mało w slajdach napisałam.
Tak, slajdy się tak skończyły dość wcześniej.
No właśnie, ale z artykułów trudniej, bo są długie. Gdy jest krótki artykuł, to łatwo jest pokazać.
Jak Pani Liza, artykuł to była, jak to? To była model of permutation model, right? To
się wszystko... Permutation,
tak. Permutowało.
Ale można znaleźć w Arce. Trudno jest, gdy ktoś się nie zajmował konstrukcjami modeli permutacyjnych, no to może być na początku trudno zrozumieć te konstrukcje, dlatego w tej pracy o uzwarceniach second countable compact Hausdorff spaces as remainders. Tam taki wprowadzający rozdział umieściliśmy do konstruowania modeli permutacyjnych. Bo ja się wtedy dopiero tego uczyłam. To i dla mnie był pomocny, gdy sobie wszystkie pojęcia związane z takimi modelami, które były później używane, zapisałam. I gdy miałam wyraźnie napisane, jakie elementy należą do modelu permutacyjnego. To muszą być te takie dziedzicznie symetryczne z tranzytywnych domknięć elementów wyjściowego i to ma należeć do filtru. Do filtru normalnego skomplikowane dla mnie to było. Także tam jest wprowadzenie do modeli permutacyjnych też zapisane.
Dobrze, to dziękujemy też za informację. Może ktoś z magistru będzie pisać taką pracę, dlaczego nie? To może się nauczyć czegoś i jednocześnie promotora. Tak.